You know, iMovie's lower third titles get the job done, but they're not very customizable. You're pretty much stuck with what they give you. And honestly, after watching many, many videos, you can kind of spot an iMovie lower third title a mile away. Wouldn't it be great if you could somehow customize an iMovie lower third title to fit your branding or the look and feel of your video? Well, here's a quick and easy way to customize an iMovie lower third title, and you don't even have to leave iMovie to do it. All right, so here we are in iMovie, and I have this sample video clip on the timeline, and I'm going to add a lower third title to this video by clicking on the title section of the browser, then clicking and dragging the standard lower third title above my video clip in the timeline. Then I'll go over and I'll fill in the text of the lower third. Okay, so now I'm going to go up and select the check mark to set my title text. Okay, I'll preview in the timeline, and the lower third fades on and off. Pretty standard stuff, right? Let's add some production value to this lower third by giving it a custom animated background using the media and the tools that are already here in iMovie. Okay, so I'm going to go up into the background section of the browser, and I'm going to go down to the underwater background, and if I scrub over it, you can see it's animated. I'm going to click and drag the underwater background down to the video clip, and notice the lower third title jumps up and out of the way to its own layer. Okay, so I'm just going to place the underwater background so it sits right underneath the lower third title. So if I scrub over what I have, you can see the lower third title text sitting on top of the underwater background, full screen. That's not exactly what we want. So I'm going to park the playhead on the underwater background. With the underwater background selected, I'm going to go up to the top of the preview window and select the video overlays settings. And then from the menu on the left that says cutaway, I'll select picture in picture. And you can see the underwater background clip becomes inset in the preview window. It is now a picture-in-picture element that I can manipulate. So I'm going to click and drag on these corner points here to stretch the underwater background to cover the entire screen. Then I'm going to click and drag the entire background down until it covers just above, the top of it at least, covers just above the lower third title text. I'll click the check mark the top of the corner to lock in my changes in the picture-in-picture. And now let's play this. Instant production value. Looks pretty good. But I'm going to change a few things just to make everything just pop a bit more. So I'm going to go back into picture-in-picture editing mode by making sure the underwater background is selected. Then going back up to the top of the preview window and selecting the now highlighted overlay button, which brings me back into editing mode. So now I'm going to click and drag the underwater background back up until it fills the entire screen. Then I'm going to click and drag on one of these corner points to shrink the background down just a bit. And then I'm going to drag it to the top of the screen so I can just manipulate it, give me some room to manipulate it a little bit. Then I'm going to grab one of the corner points and I'm going to drag it down all the way. You can see it moving diagonally, and then watch what happens. Do you see that? The underwater background flipped. The clip flipped horizontally. So why did I do that? Well, I wanted to actually use these light rays in the image that were actually on the bottom of the image as the actual background for the lower third text title. Just a you know, makes it a little more subtle, less busy than the caustic effect at the top of the image here. All right, now I'll just resize and position the underwater background as I did before. Okay, that looks good. All right, let's play this back. Much better. The text just reads a little better, but I'm gonna do one more thing. So I'm going to leave the playhead parked on the background in the timeline, and I'll make sure it's selected. Then I'm going to go back up to the menu at the top of the preview window, and this time I'm going to select the color correction button. And I'll go down to the brightness slider control here, and then I'm gonna click and drag it to the left to darken my underwater background so the text can pop a bit more. All right, let's play that back. That's nice, it's really nice. And that's not the only modification you can actually make to this. I could go over and grab the saturation slider over here and reduce the saturation till it's grayscale, the image is grayscale, or I can drag it all the way to the right to really amp up that blue color, make it really saturated. I could also grab the color temperature slider over here and I can drag it to the left to add blue or more blue to the color in the image, the colors in the image, or I can drag it to the right to add yellow to the colors in the image, which in this case gives us green. I can also adjust my lower third background using clip filters. This is really quick and easy. So I'm gonna reset the color changes I made first by going over and selecting the reset button. Then I'm gonna go up to the clip filters button up here. I'm gonna select that and then select the filter, or rather the clip filter drop-down menu over here. And we get the clip filter gallery. And we can already see a preview of what the background will look like with different clip filters applied. You can also just hover over each of the filters with your cursor to get a bigger preview in the preview window of what the clip filters will look like. So let's select day into night. All right, let's preview that. Sharp, that looks really nice. Okay, let me quickly show you a bonus move you can do with this technique. Take it up a notch, if you will. If we play this back, you can see the lower third background is dissolving on at the beginning and then dissolving off screen. And that's because if we go up and we select the video overlay settings, we have this transition style, which is set to dissolve with a duration of half a second. So I'm going to set this duration to 0 seconds so that we don't have a dissolve. And now with my background selected and in the picture-in-picture interface, I'm gonna animate the lower third background onto the screen using keyframe animation here in iMovie. So the first thing I'm gonna do is go down to the timeline and I'm gonna place the playhead at the very beginning of the background clip. Then I'm gonna go back over and open up the picture-in-picture interface. Then I'm gonna go down to the underwater background and I'm gonna click and drag it straight down until it's off the screen. I'm gonna use these snapping guides that appear just to help me keep things straight. Okay, with the background off screen, I'll go up to this little keyframe tool in the top left corner of the preview window and hit the little diamond with a plus sign in the middle to set a keyframe to store the position of the background at this point in the timeline. That's what keyframes do. Now, if I wanted to remove that keyframe, I would just click this diamond symbol with the little X in the corner. Okay, next I'll go back down to the timeline and I'm gonna click and drag the playhead around 1 second in. Just approximately there. And I'll go back to the preview window and select and drag the underwater background back up to its final position. Okay, now you can see a keyframe is automatically placed at that spot in the timeline with the new position of the background stored. So it does it automatically. All right, let's preview this. And the background animates from the bottom of the screen. Kind of cool. All right, I'm going to actually delay the lower third text title so that it appears after the background animates on, by clicking and dragging the beginning of the title clip. I'm just gonna move the endpoint down a bit on the timeline. Let's see what that looks like. Yeah, try another one here. It may take some trial and error to get the timing right. Okay, let's preview that. Good, All right, now we need to fix actually the ending of the lower third because it kind of just cuts off at the end. So I'm gonna drag the end of the underwater background clip out a bit so that it's still on screen after the title text fades out. Then I'm gonna place the playhead at the end of the lower third title text and select the underwater background clip again. I'll go back up and I'm gonna set another keyframe. Then I'll go back to the timeline, drag the playhead to the last frame of the background clip. Now, you may need to use the left and right arrow keys to nudge the playhead into the right spot to the absolute last frame of the background there. There we go. Then I'm gonna go back over and drag the background down off screen. And again, with the help of the guides, keep things straight. And as you can see on the keyframe tool, a keyframe is automatically created for this change. Okay, let's preview. Fancy. Now don't worry, you don't have to go through all of that for every lower third in your video. You can just copy and paste the title and background clips to a new spot and then just revise the lower third text accordingly. In fact, if you really want to be efficient, you could save your lower third creation as its own iMovie project, or better yet, create a collection of your custom lower thirds as its own iMovie project. And then when you need them, you just open your custom lower third project, copy the custom lower third you want to use, and just paste it into the new project. Pro-looking lower thirds using the media that comes with iMovie, but you're not limited to these built-in backgrounds. You can bring in your own still or animated background graphics and use the same process that I showed you here. A simple and effective technique for adding your own branding to your videos in iMovie. iMovie isn't as powerful as Final Cut Pro. It doesn't have all the features that Final Cut Pro has, but it's free and it's simple to use. And with a little ingenuity and by watching some of my tutorials, you can get some pro results. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.